I'm Henry Fountain, science writer for the New York Times. This is one of the boiling water reactors that's been damaged in Japan. Like all nuclear power reactors, it uses uranium fuel to generate heat. This is the heart of the reactor, where the uranium fuel is arranged in long, thin rods. At all times, water is kept circulating around the rods to keep them cool. When the tsunami came, it destroyed the pumping systems that kept water flowing through the rods. The cooling stopped, and the water around the rods started boiling away. The heart of the reactor is surrounded by a concrete and steel shell called a containment structure. This serves to keep radiation from entering the environment. When the fuel rods were exposed, the exposed fuel rods generated hydrogen, which collected outside the containment structure. This eventually exploded, blowing the top off the reactor building. Another major concern are the used fuel rods that were taken from the reactor and are stored in pools elsewhere in the building, outside the containment structure. Without pumps to keep water circulating in the pools, the water will eventually boil away and more radiation will be released. American officials say that this has already happened at one of the pools and that large amounts of radiation are being released. This is an example of problems at just one of the reactors, but the power station has six, and problems have been reported at least four of them. This has made it very difficult to stay on top of the situation.